My grandmother was a very important part of my life because my mother became a mother at the age of 16. My sister is 2 years older than me, and she was already, so my mother was only 16 years older than my sister. And because my father basically deserted her, she had to go to work, and so we spent a lot of time with my grandparents, stayed there constantly. And
did you ever meet your father? Or?
Oh yeah, it was a very had a very tempestuous family life. I once wrote up as Barry Blumberg and I belonged to this club of 80-year-olds. You know, people more than say 1925, and we've been up to his place in Maine every 5 years. He has a gathering of six or seven scientists who were born that year. And they asked me to write my autobiography, so I described all this. Basically, I have a theory that probably my mother, I have no proof of this, but my mother probably got pregnant, and my uncle was livid. Her older brother, she had five brothers, and her oldest brother was a relatively successful businessman in the garment district. He owned a company called Wolf and Barse, and later on I actually worked there. And as I understood it, he got a hold of my father and beat him up. They had a fight, and the two of them hated each other from that day forward. Okay. And every chance either one of them got to express that anger, it got out. It affected us, you know, because on the one hand, I'm not saying my father was actually not an angel by any. Not only did he never did. I don't know, my sister was born, they must have lived together, and then he left even before I was born, okay? And the interesting thing about that is that he then later married the woman who then became his sweetheart or whatever, girlfriend, and they stayed together until he died. So he's married to the same woman who I did meet. Her name is Ann, and she was actually nicer to me than he was. But I did not see my father until I was about 5 years old. He came, I can still remember him coming to, we had a three-room apartment on the fifth floor of a tenement building in the East Bronx, okay? And that's when my aunt came to live with us. We stayed in one room. My sister was in another bed. And my mother must have slept in the other room. And then there was a kitchen. And there were these two beds. My father was sitting on the one bed and I was sitting on the other, looking at him, and he says, I want to show you something. He pulls out a gun. My father was a bootlegger. Why he showed me the gun, I don't know, but you have to think about it, that he was probably, about 23 years old? And I always think about that when I think about it. You know, by that time, I was the father also. Because later on, when I got married, I was 21, and Stefan was born in 1947. So I was born in 25. So by the time I was not even 22, Stefan was born. Okay, and so then after that, I didn't see my father again for 5 years. He did everything possible to avoid helping my mother. For 10 years he did not give us a nickel, okay? And my uncle, on the other hand, supported us. So he became a kind of a surrogate father, even though I never, the only time I would ever see him was Friday night. We'd all meet, and my uncle would come frequently with business friends to partake of my grandmother's cooking, which was really outstanding. And so every Friday night we'd go there, and all my uncles would be there. And my mother, as I said, had five brothers. She was the second oldest. The oldest was Sam, the one who hated my father. And then after them, there were four others, Abraham, Nate, Hyman, and Bernard.